Well, friends, good afternoon once again. We'll be again continue our discussion on that capital structure planning. Last class, I had made you a request to write down those formulae. I think you have already written it down. And that should be readily available with you. Today, we'll be trying to solve some questions. That formula will be useful. Before that, once again, I will try to explain you that formula, how that formula has been derived. Then we'll be solving it. I am going to share with you the relevant PPTs. Are you seeing the PPTs?
Yes, sir.
PPTs are visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so yes, these are the formula. I had told you to write down this formula, then another list of formula I had given you. So basically, this formula tells us how to arrive at this cost of capital, that is cost of debt and cost of equity, how we are going to compute it. And we will be learning that thing subsequently. We will be learning cost of capital chapter. But right now, we'll understand cost of debt is interest by debt value. Interest by debt. Please, I request all of you to mute your speakers. Please mute your speakers. Yeah. Okay. In case there is some background noise, please. Well, then I am muting all your speakers. Only my speaker is on. In case you want to ask something, then either you raise your hand or unmute your speaker. Okay. Again, I think someone has switched on the speaker. I request all of you to ensure that there is no background noise. In case there is some background noise, please mute your speaker. Otherwise, all of us will be disturbed. Okay, in case you want to ask some question, unmute your speaker, then ask. Okay, now friends, this thing we are discussing, that how to compute that cost of debt, I had told you, cost of debt is interest divided by value of debt. Similarly, cost of equity is equal to EBT divided by value of share, that is value of equity. And cost of capital is equal to EBIT divided by overall value, means debt and equity taken together. This B is the entire capital. Debt plus equity. B is equal to S plus D. In this chapter, we will be understanding D as debt, S for share. Okay. And from this formula, we can derive, if KD is I by D, then what is the value of debt? Debt value is I by KD. If KE is EBT by S, then what is S? S is equal to EBT by KE. If KO or overall cost is equal to EBIT by V, then what is V? Or V is the total value of the firm. What is V? V is equal to EBIT plus KO. So indirectly we are learning, we will be able to compute the value of debt like this, value of shares like this, and value of overall value of the business like this. And this V is equal to D plus S. Why you are trying to learn this formula? Because the ultimate objective of deciding a capital structure is to ensure that the firm's value is maximized. Right? Are you getting me?
Please, yes, unmute. Sir.
Yeah. Please unmute and reply. Okay. So this is how we'll be computing the values. Okay. So once you have written it down, after that you need not mock these formulas, so you can understand and remember. And again, I'm extending the formula further. That is, KD, we know interest by market price, that is market price of the debt, that is value of the debt. Or debt is equal to interest by KD. And what is this cost of equity? Cost of equity is equal to D1, that means future dividend, not present dividend. D1 by P0. D1 by present value. Okay, present value. If there is no growth, then this doesn't matter. And in this chapter, we know that there is no retained earning. We have seen assumptions of all the four theories. There is no retained earning. There is no growth. So practically, growth is zero. So KE is equal to D1 by P0, you can understand. What is KE? Now tell me the formula of KE. What is the formula for KE?
D1 divided by P0 plus G.
Plus G, where growth is there. But in this chapter, we have assumed that there is no growth. Okay. So we can again derive then what is P0. P0 is equal to, P0 is also S. That is value or price of equity. That is S is equal to D1 by KE minus G. And what is overall cost? Overall cost is cost of debt into debt's proportion in the total capital. Total capital is V. And D is the debt proportion. So D by V into KD. So cost of debt into debt's proportion plus cost of equity into equity's proportion. This is the proportion of equity in the equity capital structure, in the entire capital structure. S is the equity, V is the total value. So S by V is the proportion of equity. So equity proportion into cost of equity and debt's proportion into cost of debt. Have you understood? That is called as overall cost. How to compute overall cost? So, first debt cost plus equity cost. This is debt cost. Debt cost is cost of debt into proportion of debt. What is equity cost? Cost of equity into proportion of equity. So, that is overall cost or KO. Or KO is equal to EBIT by V. What is EBIT? Interest before interest and earning before interest and tax. So, entire earning, and here we are assuming there is no tax. So, entire earning is to be distributed to equity shareholders and debt holders. Right? So, that is EBIT. EBIT is going to be distributed to equity shareholders as well as debt holders. So, entire money divided by value is overall cost. Or, overall cost is equal to same thing. KD into debt proportion in the total capital plus KE into equity's proportion in the total capital. The same V I am replacing it with S plus B because you know V is equal to S plus B. Now, have you understood this formula?
Yes, sir.
All this formula you have understood?
Yeah.
So, this is fundamental. Yes, this is a fundamental requirement. Yes, so, okay. And I'll be trying to again explain you the same thing in a different way. Just have a look at this structure. Okay. First, how we calculate, how to compute various things. In any form, we compute what is the revenue or sales. Therefrom, we deduct operating expenses. We get profit before depreciation, interest and tax. We call it as PBDIT. Or we may sometimes call it as the earning before interest, depreciation and tax. Or EBDIT. PBDIT or EBDIT, same thing. Therefrom, this first operating expenses are deducted. Therefrom, depreciation is deducted. We get profit before depreciation and tax. That is PBIT or EBIT. Okay, profit before interest and tax and profit before earning before interest and tax. That is after depreciation of operating expenses and depreciation. Okay, depreciation is gone, then earning before interest and tax. Then we pay interest. Once we paid interest, we get profit before tax. Then we pay tax. Then we get profit after tax, which is distributed as dividend. Okay, so this is the money received by equity shareholders, dividend. And this is the money received by debt holders, interest. So what is cost of debt? Cost of debt is now interest divided by debt. Because this is the money I am paying to the debt holders. Suppose I am paying 10,000 rupees. My debt is 1 lakh rupees. So what is cost of debt? 10,000 divided by 1 lakh. Right. That percentage is my cost of debt. Interest divided by debt. And what is cost of equity? To equity shareholders, I am paying this much only. So profit after tax divided by equity. Right. That is dividend. Dividend divided by equity. And what is overall cost? Overall cost is this one. Because this profit has to be distributed in the form of interest or in the form of dividend because tax is zero. So overall cost is EBIT divided by value. Have you understood how we are arriving at this formula? This amount is going to the debt holders.
That is the
formula. This amount is going to the equity holders. That is why formula is like this. And this amount is going to both of them. That is why amount is like this. Okay. And we have to remember that V is equal to D plus S. And here S will understand as share or equity. Okay, understood? Now, friends,
yes,
with that background, we'll move to the first theory, that is net income theory. Right? So, we had noted down some general assumptions. Is it done? Some assumptions which are common to all the theory you have noted in our earlier class. Is it done? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
So these are the additional conditions or additional assumptions specific to NI theory, net income theory. What is the first assumption? Can you read it?
Net income theory. First assumption is debt cost is constant irrespective of leverage.
Okay. Second assumption?
Cost of equity is constant irrespective of leverage.
So here point is that DE is constant. Sorry, KD is constant. Cost of debt is constant. And cost of equity is also constant. KE is also constant and KD is also constant. Irrespective of leverage. Leverage means introduction of debt in the capital structure. That means irrespective of fact, how much debt you are having, whether you are having 0% or you are having 90%, that doesn't matter. Irrespective of proportion of debt in your capital structure, debt cost is constant and capital cost is constant. Meaning, if you take more debt, debt cost will not increase, capital cost will also increase, equity cost will also not going to increase. Right? That is the meaning of this assumption. Okay. Okay. Now, now we'll see the explanation part of this theory. Assumptions you have understood? So,
yes,
this theory explains that as the proportion of debt increases, now friends, you tell me which one is less costly and which one is more costly, debt or equity, which is less costly?
Debt.
Debt is less costly and equity is more costly, right?
More costly.
So, as the approach says, as the proportion of debt increases in the capital structure, the value of the firm will increase. Meaning, hum debt agar badhayenge, to kya hoga? Overall cost kam hoga.
Yes, sir.
Because debt is cheaper. So, firm ka value kya hoga? Badh jayega. So, as I increase the proportion of debt in my capital structure, the value of the firm will increase. That is what this theory says. We'll see whether actually that is happening or not. This is because overall cost of capital will decrease. Since overall cost of capital is going to decrease, the value of the firm will increase. In other words, this theory says introduction of debt has an impact on the value of the firm. Are you agreeing? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
If you are agreeing that it has got some impact, now tell me whether it is having positive impact or negative impact. That means if I introduce debt, value of the firm will increase or decrease?
It is a positive impact.
It has positive impact. Okay, definitely it is having positive impact. Okay. Okay, right. So to understand that theory, let us see this graph. This concept what I told you, I think you have understood. Now you will understand. We assume that cost of debt is constant. You see the lower line is what? What is written here?
KD.
KD. KD means?
Cost of debt.
Cost of debt. Why cost it is straight line?
Cost of debt. Cost of debt.
Cost of debt. Why I am taking it as a straight line? Because KD is constant. Okay. Constant irrespective of leverage. Here this is leverage. Leverage means proportion of debt in the capital structure. Okay, so debt by equity, even if I am increasing the debt by equity, even if I am increasing, cost of debt is constant. Understood the meaning of this? Lower I am reading leverage, because even if I am increasing leverage, KD is constant. Okay?
Yes,
and the second I am saying, KE is also constant. You see, in leverage I am increasing, but what is happening to the KE? KE is also?
Constant.
Constant, K is not increasing, KD is also not increasing. So KD is constant, KE is constant. Okay. Right? Okay. Now we know KD is cheaper, that is why KD is lower. KD is located here, KE is located here. So if you see cost, suppose KD is let us say 10%. So KE is let us say something around 20%. Okay. That is why KD is lower, KE is higher. Understood this concept?
Yes, sir.
Okay, yes, sir. Understood now. Now what the theory says, if this is so, that is KD is lower than KE, KE is constant, KD is constant. If that is so, if I increase debt in my capital structure, that means if I'm going to increase leverage, then my overall cost will fall down. Overall cost means average cost will fall down. And if average cost will fall down, what will happen? My value of the farm will increase. Okay. Okay, understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now sir, again I'm explaining with.
Hello.
Yeah,
sir,
please ask.
Sir, if leverage is increasing, that means the debt amount is increasing?
Debt amount is increasing.
So according to this, the KD is also varies because KD is equal
KD,
to.
KD means, understand? KD, understand it as a rate percentage, not in total value. Suppose KD is 10%. Even if you are increasing debt size, KD will still remain 10%. Are you getting me? I think you are talking about, you are thinking that the interest amount will increase. We are not talking about this. We are talking about the KD as a rate percentage will remain constant. Are you getting me?
No, sir.
Who is asking? What's your name?
Sir Rojali.
Rojali. Wait a minute. Yeah, Rojali. Now, you see, our point is that cost of debt as a percentage will remain constant. Okay.
Yes,
so even if I'm increasing, even if I'm increasing the volume of debt, still it will, the cost of debt will remain constant. Okay, I am explaining with the help of an example. Okay. Now let us listen to this example carefully. Suppose aap dekhi aapka ghar mein, all of you can follow Hindi.
Yes, sir.
Sir. Yes, sir.
Is there anyone who is not following Hindi? Please respond. Okay, fine. So let us say aapka ghar mein normally ek sabji banti hai. Right? Ye aapka aloo gobi ka sabji. Aap batao, aloo is less costly or gobi is less costly? Which one is costlier? Which one is cheaper?
Aloo is cheaper.
Aloo is cheaper than gobi. Right? My point is that suppose आपका घर में कुछ सब्जी बनता है, suppose 1 kilo सब्जी बनता है total. Okay. Question is that मैं अगर आलू का ratio इसमें बढ़ाऊंगा, right? I am saying cost of debt is constant. Suppose आलू किलो 20 rupees है, मैं अगर 5 kilo लाऊं, 10 kilo लाऊं, 50 kilo लाऊं, फिर भी per kilo आलू का price वो 10-20 rupees ही रहेगा. That is the meaning of KD. Okay. Understood? Similarly, suppose gobi ka per kilo price suppose hai 50 rupees. But jitni bhi gobi lao, uska price wahi 50 rahega, irrespective of the volume. Mera sabji mein agar 50-50 aloo gobi ke ho raha hai, tab bhi aloo ka rate same hai aur gobi ka rate bhi same hai. Understood?
Yes, sir.
But mera ghar mein to 1 kilo sabji ban raha hai. Aur 1 kilo sabji mein maine kya क्या करता हूँ? As the proportion of debt increases, मतलब as the proportion of आलू increases, because that is cheaper. Okay, आलू बढ़ाऊंगा मतलब गोभी घटाऊंगा, because total मेरे को 1 kilo चाहिए. Understood? And आलू is cheaper. Okay, suppose normally ratio was 50-50, but आप बोल रहे हो नहीं, आलू को करेंगे 60, गोभी को करेंगे 40, तो क्या होगा? Cost कम होगा या नहीं होगा? कम होगा या नहीं होगा?
कम हो जाएगा.
कम हो जाएगा. That is what it says, that overall cost will decrease because I am replacing a costly corn with a cheaper corn. Exactly same thing. Here your requirement is 1 kilo sabji. Let us say in your company, there is a requirement is, let us say 1 lakh amount. Now 1 lakh amount, how much debt, how much equity will give? 50,000 debt, 50,000 equity? Or 60,000 debt, 40,000 equity. That you have to decide. And if you know this, or if you believe in this theory, that means this theory says, if I increase the cost of debt, if I increase the size of debt in my capital structure, my overall cost will decrease. Do you understand?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Now here, this case, since we are in this example, let me explain you. Particular. Once again, this theory, let me explain you regarding this. Now tell me, same example we'll take. Let us take, now you are not in home, you have opened a restaurant, similar kind of example which I have given in our last class. You are opening a restaurant where you are selling a plate of alu gobi sabji for 100 rupees. ठीक है, समझ में आ रहा है? एक प्लेट आलू गोभी सब्जी का बेच रहे हो कितने में? 100 रुपए. ठीक है, 100 रुपए में आप बेच रहे हो. आपका कॉस्ट आ रहा है 80 रुपया. 80 रुपए का कॉस्ट, बेच रहे हो 100 रुपया. ओके, आप अगर प्रोपोर्शन चेंज करके आलू गोभी का, डेफिनेटली 80 रुपया कम होगा, इज इट ना? 80 रुपया कम हो जाएगा, आपका मार्जिन बढ़ जाएगा. ओके, नाउ मेरा क्वेश्चन ये है, ये जो पर्टिकुलर ट्रांजेक्शन है, राइट, व्हाट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ दैट वन प्लेट सब्जी? जो एक प्लेट सब्जी बना रहा है उसका वैल्यू कितनी है? पहले वैल्यू का कंसेप्ट समझ लेंगे. जब मैं दोबारा एग्जाम्पल दोबारा इसको रिपीट करता हूँ, आप एक प्लेट आलू गोभी का सब्जी बनाते हो आपका रेस्टोरेंट में, आप बेचते हो 100 रुपए, उसका नॉर्मल कॉस्ट है 80 रुपए. मेरा क्वेश्चन है, एक प्लेट का वैल्यू कितनी है? ऑप्शन ऑप्शन ए 100 रुपीज, ऑप्शन बी 80 रुपीज, ऑप्शन सी 20 रुपीज. बस ये तीनों ही ऑप्शन है, आप बताओ व्हाट इज द वैल्यू?
80 रुपीज सर.
सॉरी,
80 रुपीज,
राइट? ऑल ऑफ यू आर थिंकिंग 80 रुपीज. ओके, हियर दिस कॉन्सेप्ट नीड्स टू बी क्लैरिफाइड इन योर माइंड. Value is not 80.
Sir,
yeah, please, you are asking something.
Sir,
yeah.
My opinion is 20 rupees.
Yes, that is the right answer. You see, now try to understand. 80 rupees is what? 80 rupees is the cost. Right?
Yes, sir.
80 rupees is what?
Yes, sir.
Cost. And what is 100 rupees? 100 rupees is selling price. But yes, by doing this transaction, If let us say one plate of that particular sabji will be sold, your wealth will be maximized by 20 rupees. Is it not? So this will bring a value addition to your business, 20 rupees. So when you see a plate of sabji, आपको 80 रुपया दिखाई नहीं देगा, 100 रुपया दिखाई नहीं देगा, आपको दिखा देना चाहिए 20 रुपीज, कि आपके लिए उसका वैल्यू है 20 रुपीज. ये सेल हो गया मतलब आपका 20 रुपीज बढ़ जाएगा. Have you understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So here, when we are talking about this subject or for all these issues in financial management, always we have to focus how to maximize that value. Okay. Now we are thinking we'll change the capital structure. मतलब आलू गोभी का combination ऐसा change करके value बढ़ जाएगा. So this theory says अच्छा ऐसा काम करो, गोभी की जगह आलू substitute कर दो. मतलब replace costly thing with a cheaper thing.
Cheaper.
Value will be more. मतलब आप cost को 80 से 70 कर दो, आपका वैल्यू कितनी हो जाएगा? 70 कर दिया तो वैल्यू कितनी होगा?
30.
ओके, दिस थ्योरी सेज इफ यू डू दिस वैल्यू विल बी मैक्सिमाइज्ड. व्हाई वैल्यू विल बी मैक्सिमाइज्ड? बिकॉज ओवरऑल कॉस्ट हैज कम डाउन. अंडरस्टूड?
यस सर.
ओके, आई एम वंस अगेन शेयरिंग दैट स्क्रीन. नाउ यू हैव अंडरस्टूड? Now, are you able to see the screen?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So that is the concept. So if I increase the proportion of the debt, then what exactly is happening? My overall cost is coming down, which will lead to maximization of value of the firm. And value is not cost. Value is not the selling price. Right? Value means the value addition a particular asset, a particular transaction is providing. That is the value addition. Okay? I think this concept is quite clear. Now, we'll see the conclusions of this theory. Let us read it, then I will be doing a question. The conclusion is that as the proportion of debt increases, KD and KE being constant, and KD being lower than KE, KO falls. So proportion of the debt is increasing, KD is lower, KE is higher. So as I increase the debt proportion, KO falls. If KO falls, value of the firm will increase. And this theory says that NI approach or this introduction of debt has got a positive impact on the value of the firm. Why positive impact? That is explained in this paragraph. Since a costlier fund of funding, that is equity, is substituted by a cheaper fund of funding, that is debt. The overall cost of capital keeps coming down.
Coming down.
Right. Meaning I'm replacing Govi with Alu. This means the optimal capital structure, that means this theory suggests the optimal capital structure is one which results in the lowest KO. If KO is low, cost is lower, then company will be able to maximize the value. That is the concept of this theory. Okay? I think we got some idea. Now, yes, quickly, this is the question we are trying to do it. Anyway, slides will be shared with you, but right now we'll be solving this question. So, we'll briefly just note down this question. So, we'll be solving it. Then we'll go to the next theory. Just very briefly, you take down, open a table. EBIT, three firms like this, 20, 20, 20. Interest, 3,000, 6,000, 9,000. Cost of equity is 10%. Cost of debt is 6%. Compute the value of the firm and give your comment. Right? And roughly, you just write down. Later on, you can write down properly. Slides, it will be there in the slides. Quickly take down. We'll be seeing whether value is maximized or not.
Sir, firm A ka 2,50,000.
Okay, we'll slowly be doing it. Have you taken down the question? All of you?
Yes, sir.
Okay, you have taken down the question. This is the EBIT is this one, interest is this one, KE is this one, KD is 6%. Okay, now we'll solve this question in a particular manner. Some of you have already solved it, but no issue. We'll be doing it in a particular style. So I request all of you, open a table like this now. Very slowly we'll do it. We'll be solving this question. We want to understand this particular question. Open a table like this. EBIT, just copy and paste. It is already available with you. 20, 20, 20. All the three firms are same level of earning before interest and tax. Okay. Okay. Now, what is interest? Interest amount is also given to you, 3,000, 6,000, 9,000 also you take. Okay, have you taken?
Yes, sir.
Okay, have you taken interest?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Achha. What is EBT? EBT, you know, EBIT minus interest is EBT. Is
it enough?
So 17,000, yes, 14,000, 11,000.
11,000.
Okay. Now you have the formula. Okay, who has solved the question? Please tell me your name.
Sir Nandan Kumar.
Nandan, you have already solved, no? Okay. So let us see it. Now first we'll do, what we'll do? We'll calculate the value of debt. Then we'll calculate value of share. Then we'll find out overall value. And if you see what it exactly suggests. Interest, you see, interest is here 3,000, here 6,000, it is 9,000. That means here debt proportion is less, here debt proportion is little more, here debt proportion is further more. Is it not? Rate of interest, yes, is constant. So that means the debt proportion is increasing. So we have to actually see, because of increase in debt, actually whether value of the firm is increasing or not. If it is increasing, then we will believe this thing. Right? So what is the value of debt? With this data, we will be calculating what is the value of debt. And you are having the formula, so many formula you are having. Please see how you will be able to compute debt. To help you, I am giving you the formulas. This is how you can, formulas are there. Debt is, you know, interest by KD. You know this formula already. Okay, now calculate debt.
Yes.
All these three cases, you compute debt. I wait. Just use your calculator, you'll be getting, these are the answers. Okay? Nandan, is it your answer?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, right, 6% in all the cases, so 3000 divided by 0.06, 6000 divided by 0.06. Roji, are you getting this answer?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, debt you have computed. Now, similarly, compute the value of shares. Formula is given to you. EBT is there. K is given in the question. So compute the value of share. Then we'll be computing the overall value. Overall value is D plus S.
One lakh seventy thousand.
Right. I think all of you must be getting this answer. Then what is overall value?
Yes, sir.
Add these two.
2,40,000.
220. 240. 260. Right. Are you getting? Are you agreeing?
Yes, sir. Sure.
Okay. Yes, sir. Now we'll calculate what is overall cost. We have already computed. Right. Value we have already computed. And we know what is V. V is equal to, or value is equal to EBIT by KO. Right, that formula is also known to you. V is equal to EBIT by KO. By using that formula, we can compute overall KO. Overall cost of capital is this much. Okay, EBIT. EBIT is already there from the top line, top row, EBIT. And V is also there. Just now you computed. So you can find out overall cost is this much. Okay. Right. So this shows, if you see the trend, overall cost has come down. Is it not? 9.09, 8.33, 7.7. Overall cost has come down, and what has happened to the value? Value has gone up. Is it not?
Yes, sir.
Is it done? Value has gone up. So that is the theory. That is the theory. That theory says if I substitute, if I introduce more debt, and if debt cost is constant, then what will happen? Overall cost will come down and value of the farm will increase. Okay. I will be sending you this slide so you solve those questions once again at home so that you will be able to understand this theory. Now, coming to observation part. Value of the farm is increasing, or inversely, the cost of capital is decreasing. Overall cost is decreasing with the introduction of the debt. If I introduce debt in the capital structure, my cost of capital will decrease. In other words, introduction of the debt has an impact on the valuation of the farm. Higher the debt, higher will be the value. Okay, if more debt, value of the farm will be more. That is the observation from this theory. Okay, understood up to this?
Yes, sir.
Okay, understood up to this? Okay, so we'll conclude that theory. Now, very quickly, we'll start the next theory. We may not be able to complete this today. Next class, we'll be doing it. But next theory is that net operating income. And as you know, in addition to that general assumption, there are some specific assumptions to this theory. Right? First assumption is that with introduction of more debt in the capital structure, the farm becomes riskier. So, pehla theory mein kya bolta hai? That you take more debt. If you take more debt, what will happen? Overall cost will come down, value will increase. So, naturally, everybody will see that he has taken the maximum debt. But this theory says, if you take more and more debt, okay, let me discuss that thing first of all. Now, this theory says something little different than the previous theory. Previous theory we have already understood. That means the essence of previous theory is that introduce more debt. Is it not? Previous theory says maximum debt. But this particular theory, a net operating income theory, says no. No, in this sense, because if you introduce more debt in the capital structure, what will happen? The equity shareholders will perceive that there is more risk in this particular farm. Right? They find it is more risky. There's a possibility that farm may become insolvent. That means what exactly will happen? Cost of equity will increase because they are perceiving more risky. Their risk perception increases. The cost of equity will not remain constant. It will increase. Okay, and increase to such an extent that by introduction of more debt, you will not be able to reduce overall cost. It will automatically increase. इसका मतलब आपको अगर एग्जाम्पल का साथ रिलेट करके समझाओ आप सोच लीजिए आपने क्या किया ज्यादा आलू डाल दिया ओके ज्यादा आलू डाल के यू रिड्यूस द कॉस्ट टू 70 फाइन Okay, you are understanding?
Yes, sir.
Okay. आपने क्या किया? Cost 70 कर दिया. क्या किया? आप गोभी की जगह ज्यादा आलू डाल दिए. But when you are selling it in the market is saying no. This combination of सब्जी, I am not going to buy it as 100. I will buy it as 90. तो कुछ फायदा हुआ आपको? पहले भी आपका 20 वैल्यू था, अभी भी 20 वैल्यू है. Is it not?
Yes, sir.
That means changing in capital structure or changing in that structure, debt and equity, is not affecting the value. अगर आपने और भी reduce कर दिया, suppose 70 को आपने 60 ले आओ, तो क्या होगा? Price भी 90 से 80 आ जाएगी. ठीक है? Understood?
Yes.
So that is the concept. Yes, so this second theory says capital structure doesn't affect the value of the farm. So therefore, there is absolutely no need to change the capital structure. So that theory also we'll be solving. Next class we'll be understanding that theory. Okay. And there are some specific assumptions relating to that theory. We'll be studying that. But right now, time will not permit you to discuss for longer period. This much of slide I'll be sending you. And our next class will be day after tomorrow. Tomorrow there is a break. So day after tomorrow, again, we'll be catching up around this time. 3:30, we'll be covering that. We'll try to cover one more theory also. This is how we'll proceed.
Sir?
Yes, please.
Sir, I have a question. Actually, this is my second class I'm attending of yours.
Yeah.
Previously, my chapter didn't inform about this. So today, I got the second class to attend.
Yeah.
So I wanted to ask that on the day after tomorrow when we are having a class.
Please ask the question. Otherwise, you do one thing right now. Time is going to be over. My WhatsApp number will be there.
Okay.
Either in this group
right.
or in personal WhatsApp number, please raise the question. I will be answering that question in the next class. Since time is short, I am unable to take your question. Otherwise, there is no issue. Right?
Okay, sir. No problem.
Please specify your question.